In this class, we'll try to look into the power into transmission line. In order to find the power, we'll look into the voltage and the current equation, which we have already derived in the previous videos. Now, what is the voltage equation which we have derived in the previous video? It comes out to be V x of t, which is nothing but the voltage in space and time, comes out to be V plus e to the power minus gamma x plus V minus e to the power plus gamma x. Now, this is nothing but the value, which is nothing but the peak or the RMS value. If I need the instantaneous value, what I need to do? I have to multiply this whole thing with e to the power j omega t. So, this will be what is your instantaneous value. Now, this consists of two parts. One where the voltage is traveling forward, the another where the voltage is traveling backward, right? So, what I'm going to do is, I'm going to take the part where the voltage is traveling forward. The same thing I'll repeat for the current also. I'll take the part of the current which is traveling forward. So, for forward part or the voltage part, which you can understand. So, V x of t would be nothing but V plus e to the power minus gamma x e to the power j omega t, right? Now, what is gamma? We know that gamma is nothing but alpha plus j beta, right? So, we can substitute the value here. If I substitute that value, V x comma t would become V plus e to the power gamma, I am going to substitute, minus alpha plus j beta x e to the power j omega t, right? Let's simplify this equation. If I simplify this, it will become V plus e to the power minus alpha x e to the power minus j beta x e to the power j omega t, right? I can club this together. So, it would become V plus e to the power minus alpha x e to the power minus omega, it is nothing but, let me say, omega t minus beta x, right? So, it would be nothing but right. So, this would be nothing but omega t is the positive part. So, it will be omega t j omega t minus j beta x. This will be this equation. Now, I can write this equation in terms of cos also, right? It is nothing but, I can write, it is nothing but e to the power I theta. So, I can write in terms of cos also, right? So, in terms of cos, this equation will become V plus e to the power minus alpha x cos omega t minus beta x, right? So, this is nothing but the part of the voltage which is traveling forward, right? Or I can say that it's an instantaneous value of the voltage which is traveling forward. The same way, I can do it for the current also, right? What is the current equation we know? Current equation we know, I x of t is nothing but, it is given by I plus e to the power minus gamma x plus I minus e to the power plus gamma x, right? In the same way, I will substitute gamma is equal to alpha plus j beta, and I will conclude the forward part of the current equation, which comes out to be for forward part, I will get I x comma t comes out to be same way I plus e to the power minus alpha x cos omega t minus beta x. Right? So, we got the current part and we got the voltage part. The next part thing is nothing but finding the power. Let us see how I can find the power. So, what would be the power? Power would be nothing but your instantaneous power would be nothing but the VI, right? What is power? Power is voltage into current. So it would be Vx, t into Ix, t. This would be what is your power. Now, let us write this equation all together and try to find it out the instantaneous power. So let me rub this. We will keep the equation, right? Even we will keep the current equation. Okay. So what would be the power? So P x comma t would be V plus e to the power minus alpha x cos omega t minus beta x, omega t minus beta x into current. Current would be nothing but I plus e to the power minus alpha x cos omega t minus beta x plus theta. Now, if you note, here there is nothing called as theta here. But when trying to find it out the power, I added some angle to theta, which is nothing but the current part. Why I did that? Now, what I am assuming is the current and voltage are not in same phase. It means, let us say that current has some arbitrary angle to that, right? So, it some angle, this is nothing but it is out of phase, which is I am adding some theta, right? So, that I am taking care. If the phase difference between current and voltage is 0, this theta would be 0, right? As I am solving a generic equation, so I have considered the phase as theta. So, let us see what will be the equation I can get. So, if I solve this, it would be V plus I plus e to the power minus 2 alpha x cos omega t minus beta x, right? Cos omega t minus beta x plus theta. This will be your instantaneous power. If I want to find the average power, how I can do that? It's nothing but you have to integrate the instantaneous power over the one cycle, right? So, my P average would be nothing but 1 by t of the P x comma t dt over one cycle, right? So, we need to integrate this over the one cycle, right? So, we will get the average power. So, let us see that. So, that comes out to be, if I do that, it would be V plus I plus e to the power minus 2 alpha x cos omega t minus beta x cos omega t minus beta x plus theta, right? This would be nothing but over the integration, right? 0 to t dt 1 by t, right? This is what is we have concluded, right? If I simplify this, what I can see is V plus I plus e to the power minus 2 alpha x is acting like a constant, right? So, there is nothing dependency with the time, right? So, I can take it out. So, on simplification, I will get V plus I plus e to the power minus 2 alpha x into 1 by t 0 to t, right? This quantity cos omega t minus beta x, right? Minus beta x into cos omega t minus beta x plus theta dt, right? So, what is this? This is nothing but cos A cos B. What is cos A cos B? It is half cos A plus B plus half cos A minus B, right? We will apply that formula. Let us simplify that. So, for timing, we will rub this. On continuation of this equation, we will get P as V plus I plus e to the power minus 2 alpha x 1 by t 0 to t, it will become half cos a plus b, which comes out to be 2 omega t minus 2 beta x plus theta. This would be one quantity. Another quantity would be half cos theta dt, right? Now, over one cycle, over the one cycle 0 to t, this quantity, which is nothing but cos 2 omega t minus 2 beta x plus theta, will go to 0 if you integrate over one cycle. So what I'm left with? I'm left with half cos theta. So it comes out to be v plus I plus e to the power minus 2 alpha x, right? And cos theta will comes out to be half cos theta is nothing but a kind of a constant, right? So I'll take half cos theta out. It would be 1 by t 0 to t dt, right? Right? So what will be dt? What will be the dt integration? Dt integration will be nothing but t over the sine cycle, it will become t. So tt will get cancelled, right? So this will become 1. So what I'm left is nothing but v plus I plus e to the power minus 2 alpha x. There will be half cos theta. Now, so we got power as half v plus I plus e to the power minus 2 alpha x cos theta. One more thing we know that, right? We know that z naught is equal to ratio of v plus by I plus, right? We have already seen this in the previous videos, right? So what would be I plus? I plus would be nothing but v plus by z naught, right? Substituting that value here, so that will become half v plus dot v plus by z naught e to the power minus 2 alpha x cos theta. This would be your power, right? If I simplify this, it will become, power will become half mod v plus the whole square by 2 z naught e to the power minus 2 alpha x cos theta. And what would be the unit of power? This we are calculating the unit of an average power, right? So this comes out to be watt, right? So we have concluded what would be the power in case of a transmission line, right? So we have found it out. It comes out to be half, it comes out to be half, yes, it comes out to be half v plus whole square by z naught e to the power minus 2 alpha x cos theta, and the unit would be nothing but watt, right? Now if I compare the power in case of transmission line with respect to the power in case of plane wave, let's see what is the difference here. Now as we are comparing with the plane wave, since we are trying to find out the reflection coefficient, transmission coefficient, we are saying there is a similarity between the plane wave and the transmission line, right? Let's see whether what is the similarity between the power, right? So power in case of plane waves, we know that that comes out to be half e square by eta e to the power minus 2 alpha z cos theta. This was the power, remember? Now E square is nothing but the amplitude of the electric field, right? Here you have the amplitude of the voltage V square, 2, we have a 2 here. Z naught is nothing but your characteristic impedance. Here eta is nothing but your intrinsic impedance. E to the power minus 2 alpha x here, we have e to the power minus 2, alpha is nothing but attenuation constant. Here the wave or the voltage is traveling in the x direction. Here the voltage is traveling in the z direction, or nothing but the electric field is, or the propagation is happening in the z direction. You have cos theta, you have cos theta here, right? So now you can see that these two looks like a similar equation, right? So we can say that the power in the transmission line is almost the same as the power in the your plane waves. We'll see how to solve a problem on this in the next videos.